Hi everyone, this is Derek, the UK's biggest parrot head, and I'm staying in and I'm being safe. And I'm going to watch Cabin Fever virtual tours with all of you parrot heads. Fins up everybody!
Hi, this is Jim. And until we can get the coral reefers back on the road, we're going to be doing a virtual tour of past and present shows. Also, we've got a new album coming out and we'll be featuring some new songs from that. So, wash up, stay inside, fins up, tune in to the Cabin Fever virtual tour on Margaritaville TV. Fins up. Settler show tonight, and it's such a pretty day. I decided to come out. This is Ballast Key that we're on right now. It's owned by a friend of mine, David Wachowski, who's referred to around here as Mr. Key West. David is going strong at 94, but in 1974, I think I came out here the first time. He owned it, and for some reason, which I really don't understand. He took a liking to a bunch of whacked out writers and musicians that kind of hung out at his hotel, and he allowed us to come out here and use this island. There was nobody on it at that time, no house or anything, but it's called Ballast Key, and it's the only privately owned island west of Key West. The rest of the islands out here are all owned by National Park Service. But let's just say, as I was walking around here today on this gorgeous day, because I always fished here. This is one of my favorite fishing spots, as is to a lot of other people who fly fish out here. They know about Ballast Key and the channels. And good tarpon, good bone fishing, good permit fishing. And along with that, there were some pretty good parties on this island. And let's just remember, people, that was the 70s. It was a lot different than it is now. So as I'm walking around here today and fishing and looking up, I wasn't trying to think too hard, but I know that I wrote a couple pretty good songs were written or inspired by events that went on out here on this island. So before we go in and do that show tonight, it's kind of neat to come out here and relive this a bit on this beautiful day and walk these flats, which is one of my favorite things to do. So we're going to head back into town now and go do the show. But it was great to spend the morning at Ballast Key. Thank you, Mr. Key West, David Wachowski, for Jesus, how many? 74, 84, 94, 30 something years of a beautiful island that we got to hang out on. Thanks.
I want to be there before the day tries to steal away.
Fins up, everybody. I'm Hakey with Margaritaville TV, and I'm standing in Mallory Square, home to the best sunset view in all of Key West, Florida, where tonight at the San Carlos Theater, Jimmy Buffett and the Coral Reefer Band are playing the first ever Key West setlist show. After a day of rehearsals in West Palm Beach, Florida, Margaritaville TV decided to take the famous road trip all the way down the overseas highway on A1A. We started out on the Florida Turnpike, Made our first stop in Key Largo. Stopped off at Alabama Jack's. It's a place Jimmy Buffett has mentioned in the USA Today that it's one place you gotta stop on your visit to Key West on the way down. So we stopped there, had a good time, got back on the road, kept going south, made it to the 7 Mile Bridge, drove past Bahia Honda, beautiful weather the whole trip down, unbelievable sunshine. And before we knew it, we were in Key West, Florida, home to the very first ever Margaritaville, established in 1985 on Duval Street. Now the San Carlos Theater isn't big, it's pretty tiny, and you could not buy a ticket to go to this show. In fact, to get a ticket, you had to enter your set list, your top songs you wanted Jimmy to play, and everyone who won a ticket was chosen by lottery. So to all those of you who have won, congratulations, even though you're not watching this right now. But for those of you who didn't and you're at home tailgating, we've got a great pre-roll set up for you tonight. A lot of cool things. Thanks for tuning in. And welcome to Key West, Florida for the Setlist Show at the San Carlos Theater with Jimmy Buffett and the Coral Reefer Band.
I want to go back to the island where the shrimp boats tie up to the pilot. Give me oysters and beer for dinner every day of the year, and I'll feel fine. Tin cup for a chalice, fill it up with good red wine. I'll bet you it on a honeysuckle vine. Yeah, with a tin cup for a chalice, fill it up with good red wine.
Later on, we're going to be throwing a big party because people are already lined up here, but I'm going to be selecting some tunes, and my good friend Cayman's band, The Skink, is going to be playing some reggae. It's not what it sounds like, but you can see people are already lined up here, getting their spot for, I would imagine, their show, not our show. But nonetheless, people are going to be able to watch the entire setlist show out here if they can't get in, on the beach, under the stars, under the palms, and we're also going to be giving away a couple tickets tonight to a few lucky people in the crowd who are actually going to get taken over to San Carlos and get to watch the show live there in the theater. Should be fun.
Hey, J.L. Jamison. I'm the crew chief, drum tech, stage manager, studio manager. Just all around cool dude, man. Yeah, I started working for Jimmy the summer of 84. And I moved to Key West right after that. What does Jimmy Buffett mean to Key West? Well, probably every other person I meet down here tells me that's the reason they moved here. So, yeah, I think he's done more for the island than anybody as far as people moving down here to, you know, live the lifestyle big time. He is the lifestyle. I jumped on board. I'm part of that bandwagon. All right. Oh, wait a minute. Got to take this one. Oh, that's him. Hey, Bubba. I'm actually doing an interview on Margaritaville TV. Yeah, I'm out in the middle. I'm standing in your spot on stage. Hey, you hung up. You say goodbye. All right, I'm back.
So what did Jimmy want on the phone?
A fishing guide. Knows I'm busy. Got a little bit going on, you know? Yeah, hello. Hello. The most important thing about this show to me, first of all, make sure my wife gets in. I'll never hear the end of that. Amy. Had to throw that in there. Gave you a pump, babe. Nah. Just, man, I like I said, I just hope this thing goes off flawless and that everybody talks about it for, you know, 20 years to come, man. I can say I was right in the middle of that one. I was right in the middle of that show.
Key West, Florida. Put your hands together and welcome to the historic San Carlos Theater, the king of somewhere hot, Mr. Jimmy Buffett.
Idea was this. As the song says, it's my own damn fault. So este tiempo para la fiesta esta noche en Cayo Hueso. Looking back at my background, I'm trying to figure out how I ever got here. Some things are still a mystery to me, others are much too clear. Oh, I love living in the sunshine. I stay contented most of the time. Listening to Walker, Willis, and Willie sing me those Texas rhymes. Well, most of the who retire in Florida are wrinkled or they lean on a crutch. Mobile home, they're smothering the keys. I hate those bastards so much. I wish a summer squall would blow them off. Way up to fantasy land, they're ugly and square, don't belong here. They look a lot better as beer cans. That's why it's still a mystery. Why some people live like they do. So many nice things happen out there, they never even seen a clue. But we're doing fine, we can travel and rhyme. I know I've been doing my part. I got a Caribbean soul I can barely control, and some Texas heat here in my heart. Now I might merchant marine if I hadn't ever learned how to sing. On top of all that, I got married too early. Cost me much more than a ring. But now those crazy days are over. You gotta learn from the wrong things you've done. I came off the rebound, I started looking around. I figured out it's time to have a little fun. That's why it's still a mystery to me, why some people live like they do. So many nice things happen out there, they've never even seen a clue. We're doing fine, we can travel and rhyme. I know we've been doing our part. I got this Caribbean soul I can barely control, and some Florida always here in my heart. So if I ever live to be an old man, I did, I can sail my boat to Martin Deep. Buy me a sweat-stained Bogart suit, an African parakeet. And then I'll sit him on my shoulder and open up this crusty old mind. I'm gonna teach him how to cuss, teach him how to fuss, and pull the cork out of a bottle of wine. That's why it's still a mystery to me, why some people live like they do. There's so many nice things happening out there, everywhere you've seen a clue.
Oh, we're doing fine. We can travel and rhyme. I know we've been doing our part. I got a Caribbean soul I can barely control, and some coral reefers here in my heart. I got a Caribbean soul I can barely control, and some Key West always here in my heart.
San Carlos, bienvenido a San Carlos. A little song about a street down the street, huh?
Cut her rug in here. Listens to the jukebox for her answer. Slowly guzzles 25 cent beers. It's an old song. Talks about things she's known to be so. Sees him in a dream and on the street. Well, she slides her dapper legs from beneath the table. Just right now, she can't recall his name. Perceiving she's the center of attention. Oh, the lurking eyes just look the same. Well, the weather's got the shrimper in a frenzy. They're horny and don't need a good excuse. Never do. So be careful when you go swing your partner. Someone just might take a swing at you. Never forget to die. The woman gone crazy on Caroline Street. Stopping every man that she does meet. Said if you be gentle, if you be sweet, I'll show you my place on Caroline Street.
Thank you. Mr. Michael Adley. That's some grown-up piano play. Arriba!
Thank you very much. Well, I don't have to introduce this band to this crowd, but there's old Mac McAnally right there, and Eric Darkin up there. Our happy lad from Trinidad, Robbie Greenwich over there on the pond. And I know that we've got some technically savvy people in this audience, and they're looking down, they're going, that wasn't on the set list. You are correct. So let's just talk about this set list thing, you know. So part of the process to get ready for this was we picked 100 songs to put up there, as you know. Now I thought, you know, if enough people, I thought, well, if we on a good day, if this is cool and people have enough time, we might get about 15, 20,000 people would submit a set list. And I think that would be pretty cool. So 68,900 people submitted a set list. 200 people are here tonight. And the great thing about it was we got together and learned all these songs because we didn't know what you were going to vote on. And when it came down to it, to be quite honest, you know, you voted on a lot of stuff that we knew, right, Mr. Mack?
It's true.
And that's not bad at all, but I didn't learn 100 goddamn songs not to play. So I thought I'd have a little fun myself to open this show. Your set list, the way you voted on it, will be played right now. The number one vote getting song, a Key West favorite, and one of mine too. Phil Clark, wherever you are, this one's for you. Mother, Mother Ocean, I have heard you call. Wanted to sail upon your waters since I was 3 feet tall. You've seen it all. You've seen it all. Watch the man who rode you switch from sail to steam. In your belly you can hold the treasures you have ever seen. Most of them dream, most of us dream. Yes, I am a pirate. 200 years to delay. Cannons don't thunder, there's nothing to flounder. I'm a over 40 victim of fate, arriving too late, arriving too late. I've done a bit of smuggling, I've run my share of graft, I made enough money to buy Miami, but I pissed it away so fast, never meant to last. Back one day and they still can manage a smile. Just takes a while, just takes a while. Mother, mother, ocean, after all my years I've found my occupational hazard being my occupation's just not around. Feel like I've drowned, but I won't wear a frown. Feel like I've drowned. You get in trouble in U.S. now.
Robert Greenwich on those steel drums there. Song number two. It's like a countdown.
Tried to recall the whole year, all of the faces, all of the places. I wonder where they all disappeared. I didn't
So far, you do a pretty good set list, wouldn't you say? Pray Tell, what's number four? Nibbling on sponge cake, watching the sun bake. All you lucky winners covered with oil. Strumming my six string on my front porch swing. Smell those shrimp here beginning to boil. Nothing to show but a brand new tattoo. Get one while you're here. But it's a real beauty, a Mexican cutie. How it got here, I have a clue. No stay, no stay.
Wasted away. Checking out Chiquitas down by the shore. The cruise ship's in. They dream about weight loss. Wish they could be their own boss. 3-day vacations become such a bore. I blew out my flip-flop. Stepped on a pop top. Twice I had a limp on back home. Fell off the stage, crashed an airplane. But there's booze in a blender.
Margaritaville, right? Well, Actually, the second half of the song was written in Key West. The first half was written in Austin, Texas. And the middle was written on the 7 Mile Bridge, stuck behind an overturned tractor trailer. No one was hurt, but just think of that trailer hadn't turned over, I might not have finished this song. Damn, where would we all be then? Thank you, Mr. Tractor Trailer Driver. Okay, all right. Sailors in this crowd, huh? As the son of a sailor, I went out on the sea for adventure, expanding the view of the captain and crew like a man just released from indenture. As a dreamer of dreams and a traveling man, I chalked up many a mile with dozens of good about heroes and crooks. Hell, I learned much over their style. Son of a son, son of a son, son of a son of a sailor, son of a gun, load the last ton, one step ahead of the jailer. Now what have you done in the future? Southeast of disorder, searching for song, not a lawyer, thief, or a banker. I'm still the son of a son, son of a son, son of a son of a sailor. The seeds in my veins, my tradition remains. I'm just glad I don't live in a trailer.
Everybody,
fins up
from Phoenix, Arizona.
Hey, everybody, fins up from Montana. It's Kim and Parrothead Stella. We just got our Cabin Fever tour hat today. If I'm lucky, Parrothead Stella will share it with me. Fins up, everybody. Stay healthy, stay safe.
There's our tiki bar in the background, and we got our swag on. Fins up.
Waiting for some Cabin Fever, 8 p.m. Eastern. We're getting ready here in Gastonia, North Carolina. Got the setup going. We're ready, Jimmy. Ready for some live shows. Fins up.
I don't know. I'm gonna go volcano blows.
Aloha, parrot heads from Margaritaville Northern Chapter, way up here in Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada. We hope everybody's staying safe and sane. We're staying sane by watching these lovely and great Jimmy Buffett concerts. Hopefully we all get through this and meet on the other side once again. So everybody have a good time. Enjoy loving Jimmy and...
Fins up.
Fins up.
Wasting away again in Quarantinaville. Searching for my lost mask and gloves. Gloves! Gloves! Gloves!
What's up, everybody? This is Chris from Long Island. Just want to give a special shout out to all my fellow essential workers out there. Everybody stay safe. Thank you, Jimmy, for doing this Cabin Fever tour. We really appreciate it. Everybody stay home, save lives. Stay home and save lives. Fins up.
Hey, Parrot Heads, send your home party clips to info@jimmybuffett.com. Don't forget to include your name and city in the email. Fins up!
Standing outside the chart room, which is a bar Jimmy makes reference to in his song Clichés. In fact, this is one of the first bars he visited when he came down Key West with Jerry Jeff Walker in 1971. It's closed right now, which is surprising because I didn't know bars closed in Key West. As you can see, we went down to Captain Tony's to get out of the heat. We're just off Duval Street, outside Captain Tony's, a place that Jimmy makes reference to in Last Mango in Paris, off the Last Mango in Paris album. Now, Jimmy and Captain Tony were friends the entire lifespan of Captain Tony's. In fact, this is a place that Jimmy used to play back in the day for about 10 bucks a set. And he tells me that normally he spent that 10 bucks on beer after his set, so he broke even every time he played here. Famous place, not only for Jimmy, but for Key West here in Key West, Florida. One of Jimmy's first records written in Key West is called A1A, and that's where we are right now. Mile marker zero of Highway A1A. The beginning of it, or the end of it, depending how you look at it. One of the most stolen signs in all of America for streets. I may or may not have one. There's a woman going crazy on Caroline Street, stopping every man that she does meet, saying if you be gentle, if you be sweet, I'll show you my place on Caroline Street. Never had one singing lesson. I'm standing at the hostess stand at the original Margaritaville on Duval Street here in Key West. Every time I come down here, I get one particular item from the bar because I can't find anything like it in the United States, and it's my favorite item on the menu here. So I'm gonna go right now and we're gonna eat some. So when I'm at the Margarita in Key West, this is what I order, the Kong Fritters. They got some kick, fried dough, you can't go wrong with that, right? And if you're out late at night or if you started earlier in the day, they'll keep the party going. These are awesome.
Everything kind of connects up to a Key West story, and I can't tell them all, or we'd be here for 6 hours. And but I do remember this because I was in England for the first time, and it was over there working on a film, and I didn't have any money, and I was kind of just trying to get by, and I went into a store, and I heard this song on the radio, and I went, "Damn, I better call home." And so Come Monday hit, and thank you very much. And this was for Jane Buffett, and it still is. So Come Monday, here we go.
Heading up to San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend. I got my hush puppies on. I guess I never was meant for glitter rock and roll. Honey, I didn't know that I'd be missing so. But come Monday, it'll Yes, it's been quite a summer. Rental cars and a westbound train. And now you're off on vacation. Some things are hard to explain. Yes, it's out of the soul. That's the reason we just had to go. But come Monday, it'll be all right. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown early hay. I just want you back by my side. I can't help it, honey. You're that much a part of me now. Remember that night in Montana, which said there'd be no room. I hope you're enjoying the scenery. I know it's pretty out there. Hey, we can go hiking on a Tuesday with you. I could walk anywhere. California has warmed quite a bit. So nice to be playing old Key West again. Come Monday, it'll be all right. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown alley hay. I just want you back by my side. I spent four lonely days in a brown alley hay. I just want you back by my side. Thank
you. Mr. Doyle Gresham on the pedal steel guitar, the original. This song needs no introduction. We got Finn. April Fool night. This is no joke. Some peace and quiet. I hope to see the sun again. Lives down by the ocean, taking care to look for sharks. They hang out down around Key West town at Beaver after dark. Look out! Can't you feel them circling, honey? Can't you feel them scooping around? South in May, rolling
3 days on a boat, looking for some peace and quiet. Oh, to keep her dreams afloat. Feels like a remorse. School's still close at hand. The hollery for the big white teeth. Swim on land. Can't you feel it? Thank you much. All right. Well, if you got that much energy, here's your next song. Hula, hula, hula. We'll be right back.
Fins up, everybody. This is Abby Hall from Northern Kentucky University, one of the Margaritaville University alum. We are staying home during all of this, hanging out and enjoying all of the Buffett music going on, and working from home, working and playing all day. So hang in there, fins up. We'll get through this. Stay healthy.
Paired heads, Groovy, what's up? You ready for some big breaking news? The Cabin Fever virtual tour? It's being extended. That's right. You know what that means. More Jimmy Buffett, Coral Reefer Band, shows from deep in the archives. You never know what we're gonna pull out for you, man. Anyways, stay safe. Just wanted to give you that tidbit. I'm gonna send you all back to Key West while I go back to the surf. All right, fins up.
The San Carlos Theater? I've walked by here many an evening, and this is incredible. I didn't know it was like this. They've really done a wonderful job renovating this place.
I'm gonna echo what Mike said, is that I've been walking up and down Duval in the alleys behind this place for 26 years, almost all the years I've been with Jimmy, and always dreamed of doing a show in here, and dream come true, we're playing with Jimmy, and it sounds killer. Small, intimate gathering, and you can see every single person in the place right in front of you. Seats maybe 400 or so. It's incredible.
It's more intimate, and we're able to play off of the people, and Jimmy can really focus on individuals.
Something that happens like friends getting together right off the beach and playing. That's the sound Jimmy wants, and I think that's where he came from. And of course, we play the huge sheds, we play the big venues, but it feels like we're going back to old times like this in modern day.
Jimmy brought me to Key West for the first time. He introduced me to Key West, and I honestly didn't really know any of the history of San Carlos because it's close to Margaritaville. I've walked by it a million times, thought a beautiful front, but I never saw inside the building until we came and spoke about this show. I love small theaters. It's actually my favorite. And Jimmy comes from bars and small theaters. He likes the intimate, and he's the best in the world at making 20,000 people feel intimate. But when you have a place like this, it's a whole lot easier. The place has already done it. So the band's close to one another. We can feel the rhythm of playing with each other, and we're playing these songs that are Key West-centric songs. And we're playing a set list that the fans voted. So it's a new experience, and it's going to be awesome. All right, I got to talk for a second so Jimmy can get his drink stirred. He comes from the fun part of Mississippi with the salt water. I come from the northern part where we're pretty religious. And growing up, we blamed everything generally on the devil and specifically on New Orleans. And I grow up thinking really hard things in New Orleans. And it was Jimmy Buffett that brought me to New Orleans for the first time. And it was Jimmy that brought me to Key West for the first time. And I've had a really good time in both of those places. And I never blamed things on Key West. I blamed a lot of stuff on New Orleans. But I noticed my buddies here in Key West, when Southwest started going back and forth to New Orleans, people from Key West blamed things on New Orleans. That's kind of interesting. You know, we work all week, go there for the weekend. I ended up feeling sorry for all the folks in New Orleans, for all the bad talk we did about them in North Mississippi. And I wrote this song full of good things to blame on New Orleans. There's some good things. And the folks over in New Orleans can blame it on Key West. It'll go back and forth. It'll work out just perfect. My guys are going to help me with a little ragtime. This is Blame It on New Orleans. I like the morning, fond of afternoons. I love the evening, but it's over too soon. What's wrong with me? I blame it on New Orleans. I like hot sauce, love that southern style. Try to find a way every day to smile. Quite honestly, I blame it on New Orleans. Oh, oh, some people find disturbing what goes on down on Bourbon. Beats all you ever saw, except for Mardi Gras. That's a whole other thing. I like the people, make the most of life. They take a real good thing and bam, add a little spice. But that's just me, I blame it on New Orleans. Take it, kid. I
Hey, what's not to like? And on occasion when they act unladylike, historically, they blame it on New Orleans. I like music, blues and Dixieland. I play air trombone, the Preservation Hall Band. Categorically, I blame it on New Orleans. Nola, Cafe du Monde and Mother, Cape Ball and all the others. I never get my fill, and I never will. No, sir. The whole world can sing, saints go marching in. It won't be long, they're gonna march again. You wait and see, and blame it on New Orleans. There will come a day, I'd like to think, when war's a song and hurricanes a drink. Eventually, let's blame it on New Orleans. Hey, don't blame me, blame it on New Orleans. New Orleans. Come see us at Jazz Fest.
Mr. Mac McAnally, how about it? Captain Tony, wherever he is tonight.
I went down to Captain Tony to get out of the heat. I heard a voice call out to me, "Son, come have a seat." I had to search my memory as I looked into those eyes. Changed like the weather, but a legend never dies. Said I ain't the last man going to Paris. I took the last plane out of Saigon. I took the first fast boat to China. Jimmy, there's still so much to be done. I had a third world girl in Buzio, pistol in each hand. She always kept me covered as we moved from land to land. I had a damn good run on Wall Street with my high fashion model life. Love drive beneath the African sky, just in the Swiss Army knife. I was the last man going to Paris. Took the last plane out of Saigon. I took the first passport to China. Sun, he disappeared before my very eyes. It was somewhere past dark 30, and I went back to the head. Right upon those dingy walls, the word the old man said. He said, "I ain't the last man going to Paris. Took the last plane out of Saigon. I took the first fast boat to China. China, Jimmy,
Woo, Captain Tony.
Yeah. Woo. All right. Okay. All right.
The reefers have beamed away. All right. This is okay because I decided to do a couple of acoustic things because I came to Key West acoustically. And my first gig here was actual paid gig, was a place up the street called Crazy Ophelia's, but I used to hang out at the Chart Room bar down there and just play for drinks. I was good at that. I really was. I learned on Bourbon Street at an early age. So this is a song that simply I wrote right after going to see Sunset for the very first time. And I think I'd ridden the Conk train. And always, if you ride the Conk train after all the years of experience I've had, ride in the last car backwards and be sufficiently inebriated when you do that. Not so that you'll fall off, but just to enjoy the ride. Because it's great to see West in the rearview mirror. So. I guess this is prophetic. I want to go back to the alley where the shrimp boats tie up to the piling. Give me oysters and beer. Dinner every day of the year, and I'll feel fine. I'll feel fine, 'cause I wanna be there. I wanna go back down and lie beside the stairs with a tin cup or a chalice. I'll fill it up with good red wine, and I'll hit you on a honeysuckle. Goes gliding across the water, and the sailboats, they go searching for the breeze. Salt air, it ain't thin. It'll stick right to your skin. Makes you feel fine. Makes you feel fine. And I yes, and now you heard my strange proposal. Get that Packard running, let's move. I wanna be there before the day tries to steal away and leave us behind. I made up my mind. There was no doubt in anybody's mind that this song was going to make the 27. We have sung it many different ways, and we've done skits to it. We've done everything we can to it. So tonight we're just going to do it the way we started out doing it. To that that salesman and that prostitute in Atlanta who inspired me. late night at the Marriott, 24-hour breakfast.
Friends, we just reflect. We're mirrors. We only reflect the culture that we have in America. Yeah.
When I turn my knob up. You know this love song. Come on. Voices sound so wonderful. I thank you. Had a few beers. Barney, bring another pitcher. Another round of brew. Here we go. You got it. Taste. I do. Okay. All righty. This is a neighborhood song, too. This is this was written about the Islander Drive-In Theater up on Boca Chica Key that no longer exists. So think of the drive-in like, well, if I'd go out to Higgs Beach after this over to Margaritaville because I think the party, something tells me it's going to continue. You might need to think about this song the next morning, like tomorrow morning. Let's do it, dog! Wash away the night. Drive in. Guzzle gin. Commit a little mortal sin. Good for the soul. Don't you know it can so when you're on that plane alone.
close your eyes and I'll be back real soon.
All the night.
Crush him on that pedal steel. Mr. Michael Adley, what do you have over there?
A melodica.
A melodica. How many people out here play the melodica?
Come on up.
He hates this thing. Come on up. No, let's hear it. Let's hear it, because we're in a beautiful room at the San Carlos Theater. Because sometimes out in the big places we play, I can't ever hear the melodica. I can name that tune in five notes. Do that again. Wait a minute. I'm gonna use that.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I am. I'm gonna use that. So, what are you gonna play it on this one? You're not gonna say.
It's a surprise.
It's a surprise. Okay. I guess I should start. Well, Mr. Utley's going to play the melodica with a surprise.
Solving hot. Made a love of me now. Oh.
on April Fool's Day.
I don't know.
Brought the special effects. Whoa.
That was Michael Utley on the melodica over there. I know I've got some people here from Alabama, family from Alabama tonight. So, we have any contest winners that came from Alabama? I tell you, we do. Okay, cool. Where are you from? Enterprise. Okay, I know Enterprise. Yeah. And there's the mythical Bama Breeze. Let's go down there and lose our virginity and go crazy. At the Bama Breeze, you can shoot some pool down. You can hack the fool down. Or you can play it cool down. At the Bama Breeze, you can drink some beer down there, arguably have a cheer down there, pass another year down there. Jimmy got caught smoking a joint out behind the bar, sitting in his car, and they took him to jail. Tim John paid his bail. 1984, Mick Jagger passed through town, brought the house around, signed his name on the wall.
On a website that's got me
Hi, I'm Tom Corcoran. I lived in Key West through the 70s. I actually served Jimmy Buffett his first beer in the Chart Room Bar in 1971. And I have become the repository of information about those days, which nobody seems to be interested in, except Parrotheads. I'm standing in front of Jimmy's old apartment right now that he lived in when he was writing songs like Trying to Reason with the Hurricane Season, Pirate Looks at 40, and songs like that. This is 704 Waddell. It's now part of a timeshare operation. And this is Jimmy's front door. It doesn't function very well as a front door anymore. But that's where Jimmy lived, and his visitor, Hunter Thompson, used to stay there until he started running the phone bill up to $700 a month. And then he was invited not to return, and then Jimmy gave up the apartment. But an awful lot of creativity happened on the second floor of this building at 704 Waddell. Those were crazy and creative days in Key West in the 70s. We know one person was working hard, and isn't it great that he's come back 40 years later, working and celebrating the songs that were written right here on this beach, right here.
Okay. Well, this is one of my people ask me about favorites. This has to be one of them because it's pretty autobiographical. What you hear in the song is what you get, and that's where it was written. So this is a little song. There are no squalls on the Gulf Stream tonight, I don't think, but if you catch one, it's a pretty good sight from over there around Louie's backyard. This little thing called Trying to Reason with Hurricane Season. Big storms coming soon. I've passed out in my hammock. Got us left way past noon. Stood up and tried to focus. Hoped I wouldn't have to move far. Sure could use a Bloody Mary. So I stumbled next to Louie's backyard. It's the most peculiar day. Strolling down the avenue that's known as they want it. Feeling tired, and I got inspired, and I knew it wouldn't last long. Down Havana way, they're listening as we play. There's parrot heads along the Malecon. And now
The lovely Reeferettes. Woo! Yeah, huh? Well, while you're doing the set list, thank God you thought of your children. That's all I'm going to say. Or maybe you didn't. Maybe you're just thinking that you're of your inner child. So anyway, we're going to the land of the Jolly Mon right now. Are we ready to go see the Jolly Mon Mon? So well, Jolly Man sings for his supper every night. People fed him real cause he treated them so right. Whoa, 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 Jolly Man sing. Whoa, 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 make a run ring. And they wanted him to sing on their islands near and far. He always found his way by a riding on his tongue. He told them of their joy, told them of their woes. Love to see him come, hate to see him go. Took a pirate stand. Whoa, 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 Jolly Man sing. Whoa, 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 give them everything. Jolly Man, it's over, sing your last song very well. They tossed him in the ocean cause their hearts were made in hell. Came along a dolphin, he said, Jolly Man, hello. I've always loved your singing, climb on board, don't let go. This is a little song again. It was written here, and this is just one of those things that happens when you go out and have a lot of fun and you get involved in things and you wake up the next day and you go, I did what? Where? What happened? And that was always called down here before there was high tech and before there was tweeting, before there was iPhones, there was the coconut telegraph. Jungle drums. The jungle drums will be beating in Key West tonight. Wednesday on this island, there's not much going on. A little show at the sand.
Coconut.
Here's a little Florida's for all you Florida's people that won out there, huh? And for all of y'all, enjoy your Florida's while you're here.
That's why I'm so wild and fancy free. I was really in a crazy way. My folks say it's just a pain. They were hoping for a better day. Now, in my line of work, I'll get to see a lot more than most. Write them down, pass it around. The gospel from the coast. Reflections, not just replay. Taking time to escape the maze, looking for a better day. Spend a night of my life, one night on the beaches in old Beirut. Seems that all they're aiming for there is to hang around and shoot each other's lives away. Bloody winds on a distant bay, they're looking for a better day. Looking to the right, looking to the stars to shed some light. Hoping for a breath, hoping for a break, hoping for the give without the take. Dreamers line the state road just to watch the runway show. Slouch behind their steering wheels, they just watch the big jets go streaking through the morning haze. Focal point of a distant gaze, looking for a better day. I'm back to live in Florida. Blue skies and ultraviolet rays.
So we got the ever popular John Lovell on trumpet over here, and we're gonna warm up for Jazz Fest, and we hope we see some of you there too. And if not, well, you had a little New Orleans and Key West tonight, because there's not a lot of difference between those two places on my song line, to tell you the truth. So, shall we, Johnny? All right.
Black and
happy endings, but nobody fights. So if you find yourself in that nostalgic rage, honey, jump right up, show your age.
I wish I had a pencil in my stash.
Boss, the black ain't kind. Two tone, Ricky Ricardo Jack. Coming around the home stretch here. And I'm glad this one made the list. I am, because I haven't sung this song in a long time. And I got to tell you the truth, I was waiting till the end just to kind of run over some things. And I forgot how much I like this song. So thanks for voting for it. This goes out to my grandfather, James Delaney Buffett, who kind of, I'll tell you a funny kind of, we all have great times in our lives, and we have serious times, and some of us have tragedies in there, and as a lot of people know, my father passed away a while back from Alzheimer's, but in the last years of his life, I took him on trips, and I took him to, my grandfather was born in Newfoundland and lived in Nova Scotia and migrated to Pascagoula, Mississippi. I figure that song line out. And so I took my dad back, and we were visiting around, and we went to the place up in Glace Bay, Nova Scotia, and we were in Sydney, and we had an aunt there, and she took us to the house. She said, "You want to see the house out of which your grandfather jumped out of the window and went on the ship to rescue his brother and never came back?" I went, "Yeah, I'd kind of be interested in that," where we came from. And we went and had an amazing kind of reconnection to our roots back up there. And at that time, my dad was, if you know and deal with Alzheimer's, people go in and out of it, and there's clarity, and then there's craziness, and kind of like life. They seem pretty good inside themselves, I guess, but... I was trying to ask him about it, and I said, "So after today, Dad, what did you think?" He said, "Well, I'm just glad he jumped out of that window. We'd all been goddamn coal miners in Newfoundland." So, thanks for jumping out of the window, Fufu. This is called The Captain and the Kid.
Thank you.
I never used to miss the chance to climb up on his knee and listen to his many tales of life upon the sea. We go sailing back on barkentine and talk of things he did. The world was just a day away for the captain and the kid. His world had gone from sailing ships to raking mom's backyard. He never could adjust to land, although he tried so hard. We both were growing older then and wiser with our years. That's when I came to understand, of course, our hearts still stand. About a month ago, when winter filled the air, and though I cried, I was so proud to love a man so rare. He's somewhere on the ocean now, the place he ought to be, with one hand on the starboard rail. I never used to miss the chance to climb up on his knee and listen to his many tales of life upon the sea. We go sailing back on barkentine and talk of things he did. Tomorrow, just a day away, captain and the kid. For the captain and his kid. Thank you. Here we are at number 27. I hope you've enjoyed this evening as much as we have. And again, thanks to everybody who made it possible. Continue your wonderful trip down here to the quiet little fishing village of Key West. Don't do what I wouldn't do down here. No. Do it.
Do it?
All right, okay. So this is another one of those. Fortunately, I got to write this with my good friend and great songwriter, Mr. Mac McAnally, so, and the whole Coral Reefer Band.
You remember how this one started?
No, this, go ahead.
We were talking about Come Monday, and it was like, what are those folks doing now? What are the Come Monday folks doing this many years later? It was sort of a sequel to Come Monday. That's how this
came. That's what it was, a sequel song to Come Monday, yeah, right.
Yeah. It's Come a Lot of Mondays.
Come a Lot of Mondays. That was it. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow. You remember that shit. That's great.
Dusty old brain.
Okay. All right. We're going to the coast of Carolina. Any Carolina people out there? Little roadside restaurant. We artfully complain. Ruby tells the waitress that his chicken died in vain. Most every day goes by according to design. I live this dream and still it seems I have you on my mind. From the bottom of my heart, oh,
off the coast of Carolina, after one or two false starts,
I believe we found our shrine.
And the walls, they won't come down.
But we can
decorate our climb or find some way to get around.
Cause I'm still on your side,
from the bottom of my heart.
A lot of Mondays since the fall, but that first night,
years of miles, tears and smiles, I wanna get it right. From the bottom of my heart, off the coast of Carolina, after one or two false starts,
I believe we found out.
And the walls, it won't come down.
Or we can
decorate or climb or find some way.
Watch the deal, now I watch the stars instead. They're timeless and predictable, unlike most things that I do.
I tell the wind and my old friend, I'm getting on to you. From the bottom of my heart, off the coast of Carolina, after one or two false starts,
I believe we found our strength.
Falls, it won't come down. Or climb or find some way to get around.
Cause I'm still on your side,
from the bottom of my heart, from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you all. We love
for our show. Thank you again. I earned that little glass of wine. I did. Thank you. You know, this, as I said, this was a unique show, and I didn't know where we could pull it off, but it all worked. So thanks again to everybody. And most of all, thank you for your undying loyalty for all these years. We aren't going anywhere. So. Here's to you, Parrot Heads. Thanks. All right, for anybody who's got a cousin in Miami, that's a true story. Let's see about that. We got it.
and the whippersnappers. The deadly gunboats never saw them in the pale moonlight, and they were off for Kiowa, so by the dawn's early light, the gringo in the garden called the customs man. They answered all the questions, were allowed to land. The ladies had a hairbrush and their husbands grabbed a comb. They were taken up the chrome to meet with their kinfolk. Everybody's got a cousin in my head.
Everybody's got a cousin in my head.
Everybody understands the impromptu. Dancing in the heat to the beat, they turn your clothing clammy. Everybody gets to have a dream come true. In a third world jungle, not so far away, lives a natural drummer with a dream. Satellite dish. His mama packs his bag, knots his big necktie, sends him north to her relations with a kiss goodbye. He's bewildered by the playwright and the immigration line till he sees his Christian name on the cardboard.
Turn your
Who's got a cousin?
The Coral Reefer Band, what can you say? My other family, yeah. The lovely Tina Gallickson on vocals right there. Miss Nadira Shakur. Mr. Eric Darkin on percussion. Mr. Peter Mayer hiding back there on guitar. Mac McAnally on the guitar, vocals, and many other things. Dangerous Dog Gresham, the original Steel Brian player. Fishing Roger Guth on the drums back there. Uncle Jim Mayer on the bass. Mr. Robert Greenwich on the steel drum. Mr. John Lovell on the trumpet. Dr. Michael Utley on the keyboard. Thank you all, but this party ain't over yet. I told you we didn't learn those songs from nothing. Since we're in the San Carlos Theater, I used to come and watch plays in here, so let's have some play music.
Days of old, when knights were bold, journeyed from their castle. Trusted men were left behind, knights needed not their hassle. They helped themselves to pig and peas, drank from kings on chalets. Was a stirring sight, those gypsies in the palace.
And some things never change.
boss, what's going on? You say you're coming. When? I sent Stick out to pick you up tomorrow night at 10. Okay, everybody out of here. This joint is closing down. We gotta find someone to clean this up. He's coming back in town. Hi there, boss, what's going on? You say you're coming. When? Send Mooney out to wax your car, mow the lawn at 10. Man, it sure is peaceful here. We really got it all. And if you ever hit the road again, give me a snake or call.
We're gypsies in the palace, left us here alone. The order of the sleepless nights will now soon be grown.
End up the way I started out in this town with my little acoustic guitar, hoping somebody would listen. Thank you for letting it all work out. I hope you had the time of your life. I did. Thanks a lot, everybody. We love you. See you on the road.
Now, to go weavers who call themselves sailors, play fiddle tunes under the stars. Petticoats rustle and working shoes scuffle. Then shuffle on down to the bar, where the jukebox is blasting and the liquor is flowing, an occasional bottle of wine. That's 'cause everyone here is just more than contented to be living and dying in three-quarter time. And it's dance with me, nautical wheeler, take me to stars that you know. Come on and dance with me, nautical wheeler. I want so badly to go. Well, the left foot will follow where the right foot is traveled, heading down to the sidewalks unglued, into the streets of this city so neat, where nobody cares what you do. A song is grinning, Phil is ecstatic, and Mason, he's jumped in the seat. Oh, I'm hanging on to the line from the sailboat. Oh, nautical wheeler, save me. And it's dance with me, nautical wheeler, take me to stars that you know. Come on and dance with me, nautical wheeler, I want so badly to go. Well, the sunrise will bring on the sleep that's escaped us, and everyone's off to their bed. They'll be hugging and squeezing, a little pleasing and teasing, and rubbing of each other's hair. So won't you dream on, compadre? Seems nothing affection. Oh, nothing, no reason, no rhyme. That's 'cause everyone here seems more than contented to be living and dying in three-quarter time. Welcome to my world. And it's dance with me, nautical wheeler. Take me to stars that you know. Come on and dance with me, Nautical Weaver. I want so badly to go. I want so badly to go. I want so badly to go.
Thank you all. Have a great time. Happy Easter.